Westbrook, the Cowboys, one of eight teams to start the year undefeated. While Jerry Jones lives for this hype, others aren't buying it wholesale. NFL writer Bill Barnwell says the Cowboys are going to decline as the season goes along and as their schedule gets tougher. The three teams Dallas has played so far have combined for one win and eight losses. Ryan, are you buying the Cowboys 3-0 start?
You know, I am buying it, and I wouldn't expect them to be anything other than 3-0. You play Washington, you play the Giants in Miami. You should be 3-0. But I think it's more important that they are continuing to build a foundation. We talk about the foundation with the Packers. The Cowboys are building the foundation. They're developing their quarterback. They're gaining confidence in the quarterback. Dak is building a relationship with his receivers. He's also building confidence within himself. He's getting back to that third step and throwing the football. He's understanding the timing. He's understanding defenses better. By the way, they still have number 21 back there in the back. So whenever he's ready to go, which I think is probably now, and the team needs him, they're going to be able to use him. So, of course, the offense is a top four in all of the major categories offensively. This team is building themselves and building the foundation to be a very good football team when they're going to need them better, when they're going to need it even more. Of course, the schedule is going to get tougher. They're going to have to play the Saints, the Packers, the Jets, and the Eagles the next four games. They'll have some tougher tests. Yes. However, they built the foundation early. That's the most important thing for a quarterback with a new offensive coordinator as well as a quarterback coach.
Yeah, there's a number of things in Dallas that if we just said, okay, what if they get their center, Travis Frederick, back, all-pro center? What if he just gets back and he's healthy? Okay, that would probably improve the offense. Well, what if we get Zeke out of Cabo, get him signed to a deal, and get him back running the ball, and we got through the first month of the season, and Nick, he didn't get one of those soft tissue injuries that you were worried about? Okay. Well, what about Dak Prescott? They got a new quarterback coach in John Kitna. All right. Got a new offense coordinator in Kellen Moore. And it seems like Dak has taken that next step, at least one step. To those who were watching might say he took two or three steps. My man Skip probably says he's running compared to stepping. And those are real concrete things that have happened that, you know, we can't dispute those things. Forget who their opposition was. So Travis Frederick is back. Seems like John Kitna's had a positive impact on Dak. Kellen Moore doesn't seem like the game's too big for him after a short NFL career. Now he's calling plays. And the defense, for the most part, is intact, and they haven't been hurt by their suspensions on their defensive front. You wouldn't say that's an improved Dallas team. I had Dallas in the playoffs, and now I see everything with Dak. Yes, they're one of the elite teams that we do have in the league. Just by those benchmarks right there, it's an improved team from what we saw last year, Nick.
When you looked at the NFC playoff picture, the reason you wouldn't have had Dallas in the playoffs, as I did not, was even if you love Dallas's offensive line, with getting Travis Frederick back, should have gotten back to being one of the best in football, looks like it has. I think everyone agrees Zeke, at worst, is one of the three best running backs in football, maybe the best. The defense isn't the Bears' defense, but it is clearly worst-case scenario, an above-average defense. The reason you would have been skeptical at the Cowboys is, all right, Dak versus Rodgers, no. All right, Dak Breeze, no. Dak Goff, man, maybe not. You go down the list, right? Dak Wentz, no. Unless you were talking Dak Trubisky, when you were thinking about potential playoff teams, Dak Russell Wilson, no. Well, Dak's playing like the best quarterback in the NFC. I want to make this clear. I do not think he's the best quarterback in the NFC, but through 3 weeks, he has been. Through 3 weeks, the only quarterback playing better than him is Patrick Mahomes, who just is continuing to set records. He almost has to be in a separate category for the time being. How sustainable is Dak's level of play? And once it tails off a bit, how much then can Zeke he's already fully engaged, but how much better can Zeke get than the 120 yards a game he's averaging the last two games? Those are the questions. Because I don't think Dallas is at a negative at the coaching staff anymore. I thought last year, schematically, they didn't have an edge. I think the additions of Kellen Moore and John Kitna through 3 weeks are paying positive dividends. The defense has been solid again. They haven't had bad injury luck like they did last year, losing Travis Frederick before the season. The only reason you would say Dallas is going to win 9 or fewer games is if you think Dak's about to fall off a cliff. If you think that all of a sudden the end is coming for Dak Prescott, but through 3 weeks, and really if you want to go further, through the last now 13 games since Amari Cooper got fully indoctrinated in the offense, he's been excellent.
But Brian, let me just play devil's advocate and say, look at the competition they played and look at the competition he's going to play. Does that factor into deciding who the Cowboys are going to be moving forward?
Well, of course, you can only play who you're going to play. And I think we understand that. But I think Dak has improved enough. And it's the small things to me that are important. He said this past weekend, I was a little greedy. Mm. To me, and he was talking about a passing to throw it down the field, think he got an interception. You can do that against Miami. I have no problem with that. But the Dak that we knew the first 3 years of his career, he wouldn't have been greedy. He wouldn't have pulled up from half court and shot a three.
Yes.
To me, that's a heat check.
Yep.
That's Steph Curry hit three threes in a row, and now he pulls up after half court and shoots a three. To me, that's a great, great line for Dak because now you feel comfortable. You don't do that until you feel comfortable in the offense. You understand where the ball should go, and you're doing all the right things. Now he can scale it back a little bit and get into that comfort zone where he needs to be, where he can be positive. He can be a very good asset for this offense, but he also can be explosive down the field. He has the weapons now in the receiving core. To me, this is a different type of Dak Prescott, different type of offense that we should be expecting. And again, they still haven't used Zeke yet.
Well, and that's I felt similarly about the greedy comment because when you're no longer playing the Giants, Washington, and Miami, when you have the stretch of football where in 6 weeks you play the Vikings defense, the Patriots defense, the Bills defense, the Bears defense, and the Rams defense with the Lions mixed in the middle, you're going to have to be greedy at times. There are going to be games where Zeke has 12 carries for 32 yards, where the field is constricted, and you're going to have to take shots. And the biggest concern with Dallas last year was, okay, even if Dak is going to eliminate the mistakes, can he make the big play? Mm-hmm. I am not yet ready to say definitively yes. What I am ready to say is, other than Lamar Jackson, no quarterback has taken a bigger leap forward from last year to this year than Dak Prescott. And see, you've mentioned it. He's doing it with this contract extension hanging over his head each and every week. I understand he took out the insurance policy. I get that part of it. But there is still immense external pressure for him to be great every single week and for him to stay healthy every single week because you have generational wealth waiting for you to sign on the dotted line, and he has enough confidence in himself. He's like, nope, I think I can push that contract a little bit higher.
There's a number of things that have happened. The schedule is what it is. But say they get the 4-0, they are able to beat the Saints with Teddy Bridgewater being the quarterback. They're 4-0 for the first quarter of the season. B, I said this earlier, man, we break that season down. I do believe they will struggle a month because the schedule is tough. And in that month, they'll be 2-2. But in the other 2 months, after going 4-0, the first quarter of the season, they'll go 3-1. That gets you to 12 wins. That's strong. You're going to play a lot of home games. Now, Green Bay, this year, are they able to put it together? Philadelphia, are they able to recover? But the last thing is, I know Ezekiel Elliott knows this. The people in Dallas know this. He's never lost to Philadelphia anytime he's been on the field. So, yeah, they might have a soft schedule. But the confidence with Dak, the confidence they have in going against Philadelphia, who's the only competition in the NFC East, to me, That sets up Dallas to be able to have a special type of season if they're able to keep their quarterback healthy.
All right, we've got to take a break. Brian, stick around. Coming up, is Jim Harbaugh finally on the hot seat after his team's awful showing at Wisconsin Saturday? Next on First Things First.